I'm Mariah Howard.
And I'm Julieta Cook.
And welcome back to this week's episode of TNT.
So we're here with Mr. Gorsis, and I was wondering, could you tell us a little bit about the FFA event you guys were just at?
Sure. We just got back from the PI Speech Contest. It's held every spring here in this was our division here. It's called the Holdenville PI, so most of Seminole County was there. We had Julia Coates who participated. We had Grace Blackburn who participated, and Paige Eberly participated, and Paige took third in natural resources.
And so are all those schools that competed with y'all in the same class, or is it just all sorts of different classes?
It goes off divisions. It depends on the division of your speech. But yes, they do compete against everybody from other schools as well. So to pull off third, I believe Paige had 10 other students in her class, or 10 other FFA members in her class, and she pulled third out of that, so I was tickled pink.
So are there any upcoming FFA events?
Yeah, we have our local banquet. It's coming up April 28th. We're going to kick it off at 6:30. All members of FFA's families are welcome to join and be a part of it. We're going to have some pig skins barbecue going on, free for all the members and parents as well. So April 28th, 6:30, come on down to the high school cafeteria and eat some barbecue with us.
Sounds like a good time.
Hey, Julieta, check out my Boston accent.
Wow, that's really good.
Let's see who else can do accents.
Hi, TNT. It's me, Sierra Walker. And have you ever wondered who can do accents and who can't? Well, I've decided to make that this week's challenge. Earth Christina, and your accent is country.
I want to be a cowboy, baby.
I'm here with Jada, and your accent is New Yorker.
I'm gonna go get some coffee.
Wonderful. I'm here with Ryan, and your accent is British.
It's Tuesday, I'm going down to the pub, give me a cup of tea.
Tatiana, and your accent is Australian.
There's a crocodile! Crikey!
And your accent is Scottish.
I got to go get my kilt and my bagpipes. Peace out, y'all.
And next up, we have some announcements by Mr. Preston.
Hey guys, Mr. Preston here, your school counselor. Hey, I wanted to let you guys know on a couple of things that are coming up. 8th grade through 11th grade, please make sure that you fill out the Oklahoma Promise. Okay, this is an opportunity where you can get free tuition for college. Any information that you are interested in, come let me know. The next thing is the junior high testing. All right, it's coming up in the next week or so. Make sure you guys have your Chromebooks charged, you're eating good, and you get a good night's sleep. Seniors, scholarship deadlines are quickly approaching. Make sure you get those done ASAP. Students, I know summer is close and the school year is coming to an end, but let's finish strong and enjoy the rest of the school year.
We've shown some Hallmark skits in the past.
Let's hop to our Easter edition.
I don't know, man. I just, like, really, really am in love this time, I swear. She is so perfect. I think I have to marry her. Yeah? Yeah. I think I have a plan.
I got the most groovy looking diamond and put it in the most royal purple egg for my queen, Holly. And as I was getting ready to lay these down strategically, I gave it a lucky kiss and put the purple one down in the middle. Started placing the other eggs around them so it didn't look obvious that this one was special. Then all of a sudden, I'm hearing these footsteps come around the corner, and I get flustered and I throw them in the air. And I take off running because I hear my Holly skipping around the corner. Nothing could make today bad, except Brad, my enemy.
Brad. Chad.
Thank you. a way we can solve this.
A battle to the death with poems from our breath. I lie awake at night writing poems that describe my love for you, Holly. And nightly I'm reminded of just how I cannot describe my love for you. Holly, my love, words cannot describe, for you're lonesome like a dove. Please, please be mine, because you are oh so fine. So Holly, please be a part of my tribe, for my love for you I truly cannot describe.
Golly, Holly, you make me oh so jolly. My love for you grows like Pinocchio's nose.
Next up, here's Julianne B. with some information about cheer and T-stepper tryouts.
Hey you guys, my name's Julie Coase and I'm a senior cheerleader.
And I'm Brianna Porter and I'm a senior T-stepper. And we want to inform you that tryouts are coming up. Clinic days will be May 2nd, May 3rd, May 9th, and May 10th.
Get your chance to cheer on the Konawa Tigers May 11th at tryouts. Go Tigers!
Hey, Julieta, so Earth Day is just right around the corner.
Let's see what Ms. Sewell and Ms. Wilson have to say.
Hi, my name is Ms. Sewell, and I'm here to give you a little bit of information about the history of Earth Day. It was started originally by a politician from Wisconsin named Gaylord Nelson, and the very first Earth Day was April 22nd, 1970. And Gaylord Nelson was very concerned about some environmental issues that he didn't feel like the government was addressing, and he wanted to bring more attention to those. And he chose to do the first Earth Day on a college campus, and he chose the date of April 22nd because it was halfway between spring break and the end of the semester, and he felt like he would get more student participation that way. How long have we been celebrating Earth Day at Konawa, Ms. Wilson?
I think we came up with about 5 years.
I think so.
So we are going to celebrate it on the 20th this year. Earth Day is on April 22nd every year, but we're going to celebrate it on the 20th this year so that we can include all of our students. Spring is just a crazy busy time for us here at the high school.
What all events or activities can kids participate in this year?
Volleyball, tennis. We're adding a fishing tournament this year. Cornhole.
Live music.
Oh, live music.
If you're a musician,
yeah,
or a singer.
Yes. We have hamburgers, hot dogs, chips, and water for everybody to drink.
I believe there are sign-up sheets on the board or the wall out in the student center. There should be, you need to get your volleyball team together. How many people
six
need
person.
To be? Six-person volleyball team. Your tennis partner. I happen to know of one particular coach whose partner graduated last year, and I think he is. Somebody better be hitting him up, because Ms. Patterson and Jacob Leslie are defending champions.
So what does Earth Day mean to you?
Well, originally we started our Earth Day celebration just so we could kind of get kids outside and enjoy a nice warm spring day and all the testing and everything that's been going on. But I think there's really more of a meaning to it than that. What do you think?
I like to think of it as just reminding people to do all the little things for the environment. one of the little things is just don't litter, because that's kind of like a pet peeve of mine. So just reminds us to take care of planet Earth.
Speaking of which, at the end of Earth Day next Wednesday, we would ask that everybody would kind of hang around and help clean up the trash, especially if it's windy, because people's napkins and chips bags and all that kind of start to blow around. So we'd ask that all you guys put your trash in the trash cans. We'll make sure there's trash cans and trash bags out there. So we don't want to make Earth worse as we celebrate Earth Day.
Yeah, because we want to have another one next year.
Yes, bigger and better. Every yes. year it gets bigger and better. So be there, be square.
Our softball girls had a tournament in Wetumpka last week.
Let's check out these highlights. Of dirt sitting out in front of the school.
I have the terrariums for Miss Sewell's biology class.
That's awesome. Let's check them out.
It's fun.
Good.
Got to find critters and scare people.
Well, me?
Yes.
Oh. It was good. Got out of the classroom for once.
Three days to get everything.
This one took me one day. He just slow.
Well, honestly. I got more stuff than you. To show how the water cycle works and the atmosphere cycle works and the oxygen cycle as well.
I got two frogs, some roly-polies, wild onions, some rocks, and this one. What about you?
I got 8 or 9 frogs, a snake, roly-polies, millipedes, and snails, onions, and dried leaves.
I heard Tyra made a blog for JOM.
Really? Let's see what she did.
We're about to leave. How's everybody feeling?
Good.
Feeling good?
Ready.
We're pumped. How about you, Jackson?
I feel great. Feel great. How about you, Mason?
I'm extremely tired. I'm going to sleep this entire trip.
Just know you feel.
I feel aight.
Really?
I don't know. I'm excited. Are you excited?
Yeah, we're excited.
Yeah, we're excited.
I'm excited. Oh my gosh. I'm excited and tired. Who's gonna take it? Yeah.
I'm very excited. I'm gonna fix my glasses so I can see the game.
And we're gonna ride roller coasters.
Let's get a word from our bus driver.
Not really. I'm just.
Here's our bus driver.
my.
How are you feeling? Are you ready to drive?
I'm just sitting here for right now. You're about to drive.
If we drive, we're not making it. So, I'll vlog again when we get somewhere exciting.
We're in Davis right now at the fried pie place.
Big Gorilla.
It's our friend. So, let's see how what everybody else is doing. I think they're getting pies right now.
Ooh, hot.
Ooh, that looks good, not hot.
Okay. We're at Bucky's. How we feeling?
He said 15 to 20 minutes in here, but it's gonna be longer than that. So
I want a burrito.
I don't think I have burritos.
I'm gonna get a t-shirt. This is the boys' room. Five in a room.
Wave or something, geez.
They're cuddling, playing Cards Against Humanity.
Bread trolley.
How's everybody feeling?
Good.
Ready to go.
Good. Ready to catch a ball.
I'm
going to
duck.
Runner advances and scores. What's that called?
Don't know.
Guess.
Home run.
What's it called when you hit the ball over the fence behind center and you score runs?
Touchdown?
How many innings are there in baseball?
Seven.
What does the number 9 represent on the baseball field?
The left field.
What are you supposed to do when the ball's being thrown at the bag you're running to?
Dive or slide.
Name 3 MLB teams.
The Lakers, the New York Giants, and Clemson.
What is the circumference of a baseball?
9.
9 what?
2,000 years later.
Made it on the trolley. And look how crowded it is.
It's so bad.
There's 3 of us and I'm pretty sure a one-seater seat.
Few inches later.
At the Ranger game, Ranger win, having fun.
I think the Angels are going to win this one.
I think the Rangers got it.
The next morning.
This is the Jalen trip. We finally made it to Six Flags. My first time being here. I'm so excited. How do y'all feel about the Six Flags trip?
I'm excited.
We're about to ride the carousel together as the whole JOM crew.
It's a tradition.
It's a tradition. Us and the girls.
There's probably more people around here somewhere.
We're about to go on a baby ride. How are you feeling? The first baby ride of the day.
It's not a baby ride. It's a real ride. It's not a baby.
She's scared to death.
Of tears later.
Jaylene, how was that?
That was not a kiddie ride. That was not a kiddie ride. It was not. I don't care what you say, that was not a kiddie ride.
So now we're going to ask how everybody's trip was.
It was good. It was good. I'm very tired.
It was good. Me and Cheyenne got our own room. We got to swim with Six Flags and we ate amazing food.
Yes, it was an awesome trip. I got to have a share room with my best friend and my head hurt a little bit, but it's okay. Like, it was an awesome trip.
We're really on our way with y'all's drinks.
The trip was good.
It was all right. There you go.
It was fun.
Fun tiling head hurts.
It was pretty fun.
I don't know. I had fun. Did you have fun?
Well, feels pretty cool.
A lot of fun.
It's pretty freaking wild.
Julieta, sometimes I feel like the school just needs a little bit more positivity.
Can you tell me something good?
Mariah, tell me something good.
There are only 14 more school days left.
Yeah. Ryan, tell me something good.
God is good.
Tell me something good.
Fish.
Tell me something good.
Peyton is good.
Tell me something good.
Italian boys.
Tell me something good.
Italian adult boys.
Jacob, tell me something good.
Graduating.
Yeah.
Tell me something good.
I heard some of our high schoolers got chosen for Christopher's game show.
Could you answer these questions?
Welcome to Have You Paid Attention in School, where we ask questions that you've probably been taught in school. At least hopefully you have by now. This time here with Jason Walton, freshman, and he's going to be representing the freshman class. Are you ready for Have You Paid Attention in School?
Yes, sir.
All right, let's get down to these questions. Question one, what is the powerhouse of the cell? A, mitochondria, B, vacuole, C, cytoplasm, and D, nucleus.
A, mitochondria.
And he is right. The mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell. Let's welcome our next contestant down to Have You Paid Attention in Class, Milena Whitekiller.
Hi.
Milena, are you feeling confident about Have You Paid Attention in Class?
Not really.
Ah. Well, sometimes you'll just do it, you know? Believe in yourself.
Okay.
All right, let's get into it for the first question.
It's the mitochondria.
That is correct. You got the first question right. Question two, what is element C on the periodic table? A, carbon, B, lead, C, chromium, or D, hydrogen?
A, carbon.
And that is correct. That is answer A.
I'm just gonna say carbon.
Correct. Carbon is element C on the periodic table. This question will not be multiple choice. What is the definition of animosity? I will use it in a sentence. The animosity between two nations eventually propelled them to war against each other.
Hatred, like the hatred of the two countries?
That is correct. Hatred or conflict. Question three.
Is it kind of like tension or whatever? I don't know.
Yes, tension, hatred, or conflict. That is correct. You've made it halfway through. Great job.
Thanks.
You're ready for question four?
Yes, sir.
There's going to be a big ramp up in difficulty. All right. What is the largest ocean? Pacific, Mediterranean, Atlantic, or Arctic?
Pacific.
And that is correct.
I'm going to say Pacific.
And you got it. Great job. Are you ready for question five?
Yes, sir.
All right. Question five. Who created the assembly line, drastically improving the production of the automobile? Henry Ford, Louis Chevrolet, Kichiro Toyota, or Horace Dodge?
A.
Henry Ford, is that your final answer?
Yes, sir.
Well, sorry, man. But you are right! You win! Have you paid attention in class? Thank you for coming down here, Jason. You have a wonderful night.
You too, sir.
I'm gonna say the last one. I don't know, though.
Henry Ford, is that your final answer?
Yes.
Henry Ford is the right answer.
Let's go.
You are a winner on Have You Paid Attention in Class? I messed that up, but let's keep on going anyway. Congratulations. Thank you for coming down to Have You Paid Attention in Class, and you have just shown that the sophomores are rocking it. You have a wonderful evening.
You too.
Thank you for tuning in to this week's episode of TNT.
We'll see you next time.